Hello, my name is Roy Simpson. I'm a professor of mathematics at Cosumnes River College in Sacramento, California. And in this video, we're going to go ahead and compute the Taylor series expansion about x equals 1 for the following function. And just to let you know, so Taylor series expansions are polynomials themselves. So why would we want to transform a polynomial into another polynomial? Well, there are actually a few answers to that question, but one of them is what we can see when we're at the end of this video. So let's go ahead and at least first start with the Taylor series expansion, and then we'll describe the issue or the reason why we might want to do this at the end. So let's see. I know that the Taylor series expansion, assuming the Taylor series expansion exists, I should probably say, is going to equal the summation n equals 0 to infinity, the nth derivative evaluated at 1, because we're centering at 1, over n factorial, times x minus 1, again, because we're centering at 1, to the nth power. And so this will require us to find the derivatives at 1, right? So, not 0. The function evaluated at 1, I keep writing 0. The function evaluated at 1 is going to be, well, you can see here, it's 6 minus 4, which is 2. And then you also need, obviously, the derivatives. So let's go ahead and find out what the first derivative is. It's 4x cubed minus 8x. And so f prime at 1 is going to be a negative 4. And then f double prime of x is 12x squared minus 8. And so f double prime at 1 is 4. And then finally, not finally actually, f triple prime of x is equal to 24x. And so f triple prime at 1 is 24. And you should probably check my math as we move forward, just because I could easily barrel through and make a minor mistake here. The fourth derivative of x, of the function at x, is 24, and so therefore the fourth derivative at 1 is 24. And finally, if you take one more derivative, the fifth derivative is going to be 0. Thus, the nth derivative evaluated at 1 is going to be 0 for n, for all n greater than or equal to 5. Okay? Just because the derivative for 5 and on, it's just going to be 0. All right, so let's plug these in. This is equal to, when n is equal to 0, I get the 0th derivative, or the value of the function at 1, which we said is 2, over 0 factorial, times x minus 1 to the 0th, plus the first derivative evaluated at 1, which is negative 4, over 1 factorial x minus 1 to the 1st, plus the second derivative evaluated at 1 over 2 factorial times x minus 1 squared, plus the third derivative, which is going to be 24, 3 factorial x minus 1 cubed, plus the fourth derivative evaluated at 1, 24 over 4 factorial x minus 1 to the 4th. And then we know that the 5th derivative and the 6th derivative and so on and so forth are all zeros. That should kind of make sense, by the way. We have a 4th degree polynomial here. In the end, it's Taylor series approximation, or it's Taylor series expansion, should also be a 4th degree polynomial. Let's go ahead and rewrite this. And in fact, what I'm going to do, just because I want to, I'm going to say, therefore, x to the 4th, let's see, so minus 4x squared plus 5 must be equal to, let's see, we have 2 minus 4x minus 1. Let's see, that's going to be 4 over 2 factorial is just 2. So plus 2x minus 1 squared. 3 factorial is 6. 6 goes into 24 4 times. So that's 4x minus 1 cubed. And finally, 4 factorial is 24, so that's just going to be a plus x minus 1 to the 4th. Well, those two polynomials are identical. So this is f of x, and the left-hand side is f of x as well. And so we're technically done with the problem, but I want to talk about something for a moment here. There are actual great reasons to recenter polynomials. They mostly occur actually in differential equations, but there's some interesting reasons to recenter polynomials for other cases. One being that if you're constantly working with derivatives of your function, so if I'm working with the second derivative of f all the time, and I need to evaluate that at one, it's much easier to have it in this format. There are also, that's kind of a trivial example, honestly, because we actually computed the second derivative of f at one already. But there are really cool reasons to have these centered at something other than zero. But like I said, that will the importance of that will not be so obvious until later on in mathematics, once you're in differential equations. But up to this point, I hope that this video at least helped you understand how to compute the Taylor series expansion for a given polynomial.